He's taking the faith train.
That's a good train to take.
The faith train. Yes, gonna take the faith train.
Thank you.
good?
I change it into a worship song. Good.
He's like, he does that.
I think people like, people really, I think, are starting like more and more something different anyway.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
The yeah. different. Yeah. Oh, Lord.
water, the fresh wind of my spirit.
My heart beats for you.
Yes.
It has different beatings, different rhythms for each of you are different. Yes. But one.
For this is a day and this is a time in which the tropical winds shall blow. They shall blow your heart. They shall blow upon the winds of your soul. They shall blow and they shall cause a fresh awakening of my love that is within you. It will cause the warm breezes to cause you to come up and run with ease and run with delight. For this is a time of celebration of my new graces. From my new graces that I have to take you and walk with you in this new season of delight. And yes, the world may tarry, and yes, the world may look in other directions, but I cause you to come forth and to take my hand and to allow the cool and the warm breezes to surround you with my love.
Gary, as you were doing that drum, I saw, felt in the spirit that it was kind of like a preparing us for a war, but preparing us as a unified team. It was almost like a call to unity in the midst of the battle, kind of like a lot of times when the kings would, or an army general would encourage all the troops right before they go into battle, not to fear and to fight with valor. It's kind of what I was seeing.
I really felt that what came to me was of the hidden gold.
Yes.
That is in each person. Mm-hmm. Yeah. This, what we just heard, has been hidden gold.
Mm-hmm.
That's coming to the surface.
Yeah.
And I just felt the Lord saying that there's so much hidden gold and value in each person.
Mm-hmm.
If we will allow it to come up.
What I heard was to permit him to do the polishing. Because of what you've been through. When we hold on to the offense of what we've been through, our armor is dull. Our swords are dull. He's saying, let him have his way in you, that you may give him glory in this place when it's time to worship the King of Kings. That you may be grateful for everything he's done for you, and that you would have a real appreciation for who he is to you in this time, in this place, for this season. Because we are in season, things are going to change. But he wants to have his way in you, who are the living vessel of what he wants to demonstrate. You are precious gold, and you've been into the furnace. He's put you in and he's brought you out, and he's put you in and brought you out. And here's a place of water. Water causes the tempering of the metal. Because when you put it in the furnace and you bring it out and you pound it and you shape it, you put it in water to temper it, which makes it hard so that it doesn't break. Same with you. Same with us all. To him be the honor and the glory for what he's made and what he's done. That's where we want to go.
The gold is going to start showing through the season for the gold to be revealed.
It's like a plant that's been underground. When it's ready to come up above the ground, nothing can stop it. And it's going to be the Lord that brings the gold up.
You are not hopeless anymore. Somebody
here in the Father's love.
sense that we are surrounding a wagon, like a pioneer wagon, and there's no team on it, and there's no team of horses pulling it. We're in front of it, we're behind it, we're on the sides of it. But it seems to be like the guidance for this wagon, this old covered wagon, is like, I don't know if everybody is familiar with curling, when they launch the ball and then they massage the ice in front of it to make it move. And so that's the sense I get, is that's how this wagon is moving, is we are like curling, we are preparing the way in front of it so that the wagon is can move forward effortlessly.
Thank you.
Jesus.
Unchained melody, yeah.
Yeah. Unchained Jesus.
I love it.
Would you, since you have anointed your hands, can you just go put your hands on him? And then I'm going to stand behind you.
Thanks, Mark. Thank you. Thank you, all of you. I feel very blessed to talk to you, bringing me into the presence of other Christians. This has been a big event for me in my life.
I got oil on my hands. You might have to put it on your hands.
Of course not.
Instead of your clothes. Yes. I'm gonna ask.
Can you stand in front of him?
Facing it? Oh, yeah, I can see you.
Yeah, that's fine. Just stand in front of him. And then I'll stand back here.
So just so you know, Israel means overcomer with God.
Now, Tim, just go ahead and pray what just comes up. And if there's any prophetic words that come forth, even not associated with the healing, but anything that comes forth, just make sure that you share it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm picking up, it's Mark, right?
Yes, sir.
Is you're like a priest that's standing next to the wailing wall, and it's like the Torah or the piece, the square piece of, it's a emblem, or it's what the men use because it represents the Word of God right on your forehead. Mm-hmm. And so it's like you're facing the wall of petition, and you're embracing the Word, the Word of God in your intellect, in your understanding, so that you can apply your heart to wisdom. Mm-hmm. And you're just posturing yourself, and you're in you're just in a focused place, and a place to give your heart, to give attention to your master, to your savior, to your lover, to your love, to the one that loves you truly like no one else can or ever will.
Yes.
And you're just delighting and just giving your heart to him. Mm.
Anybody else have anything?
I just feel so overwhelmed that God loves me so much. And it's brought me full circle again.
Yes.
It doesn't let me go even when I just think of no hope. It just never has failed me. Mm-hmm. Even when I didn't know him.
Yes.
Look back at my life and realize all the things I did. And he was there every time.
Yes.
Ever.
He's the God who sees you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I'm hearing right hand man.
Yes, Father.
You're one of Dad God's right hand men. He loves your heart.
Yes, Father. Yes, Father.
From one who has been hidden, I will hold my right hand over you.
Yes.
I will extend my right arm and call favor upon you. In ways you have never imagined, I will give to you so that you have no lack. I will cause confidence to rise up in you. You will walk from fear and never give it place. Your song will be a song of joy.
Yes.
Your song will be a sound of rejoicing. I am holding my right hand over you. Fear not.
Yes.
For I have called you. And I know your name.
Yes.
Fear not. But prepare to rejoice.
Yes.
He's going to give you every reason to rejoice.
Yes.
And you shall, in the congregation of the righteous, give voice to
yes.
your joy.
Yes, yes,
yes. You have a song.
Yes.
You have a sound.
Yes.
It belongs to me. It is mine.
Yes.
Give it to me. Where I have
yes.
put it in you, and it must come out.
Yes.
Release without reserve.
Yes.
What I have put my name upon you and within you.
Yes.
Live and walk in that I paid for.
Yes.
It is yours.
Thank you.
So I see a few things. For one, I want to pray that when you are under, that you will see heaven.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
That's awesome.
And the touch of heaven.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
Yes. And even the finger of God touching
yes.
your eye
yes.
to
yes.
heal it.
Clear vision.
Thank you, Lord.
Clear vision.
Yes, sir.
And as you're coming out, you're going to be ministering to those around you.
Yes.
You're going to be singing praises to God.
Thank you.
Not knowing
yes.
what you're doing.
Thank you.
Yes. You're just going to be singing praises
yes.
to God. And they will hear. And they will be touched. For God does desire to use you. In ways that you don't even know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Jesus.
Yeah.
Lord, I thank you, Father. Did you have any?
Go ahead. I do have something that I can do.
No, go ahead. Just speak up.
I just hear in the verse, though the righteous fall seven times, they get up, something like that. And I just feel like the Lord is so proud of you for getting up each time you fell, because a lot of people would not have gotten up. And so I feel like you have the, God's developed in you the, I think it's the fruit of perseverance. And because of that, he's going to grow new fruits, many new fruits, because I see all colors of the rainbow.
Yes.
And so I see that God's going to develop many fruits through you, and you're going to be a very fruitful tree with different types of fruits because of your perseverance to get up every time the enemy had tricked you. You got up, as the Lord is so proud of you for that. It doesn't hold things against you. It doesn't hold that stuff against you.
So Dan, go ahead and put your hand back there.
Okay.
We just speak to our brother's spiritual backbone. Jesus. And we speak a strengthening.
Yes.
By the word of the Lord, we speak a strengthening to his spiritual backbone. And everything that has tried to come and attach itself to his, the strength of you, how you've called him to stand and the man you've called him to be. Father, we take a stand in the spirit around about him today. And we say, as his brothers and sisters in Christ, we say no more. No more. No more. Strengthen. Strengthen, strengthen this spiritual backbone in the name of Jesus. And I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying, Son, I've gone with you in the highways and the byways, and even the things that have been spoken around about you tonight have even been like what we, like the song that came forth earlier today, where it was winds like island breezes that just engulf around about you, the gentle breezes of the islands, Father. We thank you, Lord God, that you even and you direct the winds to come according to the temperament of the Spirit. So one moment they will be cool, one moment they'll be warm, but they're all appropriate for the time and season you have this fine young man. Lord, because you see me, and that is purposely said.
Yes.
So the way that your heavenly Father sees you is not the way you, is not according to the way you see you. And there's a breaking out of the a sense of isolation, for just even as an island, a man cannot be an island unto himself. There is a call and the sound of the brethren, of the word of the Lord to come around about you and for you to receive the comfort and the strengthening and the encouragement for this next season. There's going to be a great building up and a great maturation that will come forth and even cause a solidification of the word of the Lord and the call. And there is opportunity for you, even the, where the enemy has come. I know you've said this, the enemy has come to take your sight, but the Lord says, I am your sight.
Amen. Yes.
Amen. I am your vision. I am your vision keeper, and I am your vision maker. And that even as you go through this season of strengthening, that there is new vision that's coming to you. I'm sorry. There's new vision that's coming to you, and he's going to fine tune the way that you see. And then that I see the heavens just like bursting forth and causing this, like where the clouds have been there, that the clouds are blown away and you see clearly down the road and the path in which you must walk. And so, Father, we just thank you, Lord God. We thank you for your hand of protection upon our brother. We thank you, Father God, for the mighty strength that you are causing him to rise up into. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Father God.
Thank you, Lord.
And I just see you screaming at the top of your lungs, I was blind, and now I see.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
He says, I will meet you in the place you think not. Mm-hmm. I will meet you there to provide and show you the love that he has, which he says, I have for you. Mm-hmm. He is jealous of you. Mm-hmm. And he's going to open up zealous in you for him and let it come out.
Yes.
In Yeshua's name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. So, Mark, I'm just gonna. This is kind of. I mean, this is what I'm feeling. Talking to. So, I get the sense that you're having a hard time receiving just how good God is. That He really does love you. And I'm just gonna hug you, and I want you to receive it from the pop from Papa. Mm-hmm. Okay, from the God of Heaven. There's nothing more that He wants you to do is to receive His love and how important and how valuable you are. And it says that brothers, He dances over you with joy.
Family.
He is celebrating.
Brothers,
He loves you.
Brother, your family, you're not alone.
In my face at work and everything, very politely, but
nevertheless,
I've been preached to before. It was hell and damnation, and that makes you want to run away.
Yeah,
but Dan has just been an amazing friend and brother to me.
Yeah.
I play music now, and I haven't played in forever. And my old dream and wish was to pray worship God, but I never really experienced it.
Wow. Praise God. And you're doing it.
Yes, I am. Thank you.
Thank you,
all of you.
And you know, Mark, he says, you know, he doesn't waste your sorrows.
That's right.
He works them all together for good.
Yes.
And for your testimony. That's right.
I thought it was real interesting that here we were standing all around you, and you were testifying of the goodness of God. And it felt like this is just the beginning of your testimonies. It
I
felt
have this
like
since I met him, a lot of stuff has happened for the better, and
praise God,
has put this guardian angel in my life.
Yeah,
yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah,
thank you, Lord.
Well, you'll get to be that for somebody else.
Yes.
You'll be playing this song tomorrow night. I can see clear. The rain is
gone. I love that song.
It's gonna be a bright sunshine day.
Boom!
You know,
cool.
Something, hope this isn't a rabbit trail, but I told Nate the other day I had a dream. It was about the wheat and the tares. And you know what? Seeing you come in to me is part of that dream of the wheat being bundled and brought in, the harvest coming in.
Yeah.
It was like a week ago I had this dream about, and I saw many people, or I saw people in cells. I saw the tares is what I was seeing. Mm-hmm.
Like cells, like prison cells?
Yeah, like prison cells. I saw people being put in these things, bound up, like they were being gathered up. That's what I really felt in the dream.
Wow.
But there's also the wheat. And the one thing the Lord reminded me of is when all are gathered, which there's the gathering. I really felt the Lord say that He's gathering. But when they're all gathered, the harvester then comes for His harvest. The Lord comes for His people to get His harvest. But anyway, I just said that to say that your part, to me, it's the harvest of the Lord coming in that's been out there. He's bringing in his people, you know. And anyway.
Yeah, so much for telling God my plans. He always tingles every time I say that. Seriously.
This is my plan, like, going.
You know, my 3 months here to help my brother Fred. I never left because my brother really needed me. In that, there was a lot more to it than that. God just definitely had showed me. And I started meeting Christian friends and got out of my non-Christian house of people and back safe with my brother, and I'll move out again, but I'm not even going to plan that one.
I wanted to share something that went along with the wheat and the tares. Just a few days ago, the Lord was reminding me about that and the difference between the wheat and the tares. I'm not a farmer, so I don't know this for a fact, but I've heard that they look very much the same. And you can tell the wheat because when it's ripe, it bows over. We bow before the Creator.
But the tares stand straight up.
The tares stand straight up, and they're facing up the same creation. The tares stand up, but the wheat bows. And so I just want to bring that because
I'm glad you said that.
When the Lord showed me how much Mark, he loves your heart. Your heart bows. You have a heart that bows before the Lord. So I just wanted to bring that up.
I'm actually just reminded of your prayer meeting probably four or five months ago. And that's the vision I actually saw. It was literally a wheat field. And I saw the wheat bowing down. And the tares still just pop, you know, just, that's actually what I saw in that vision. And so, yeah, your dream totally confirms that. And did you say the wheat was being kind of bundled in bundles?
I actually didn't see wheat. I just saw people, but I knew it was the wheat and the tares. I knew in the dream that's what was going on.
So the wheat that was coming together, did you see them kind of coming together like in little home group type things or just like?
No, actually, I saw more of the tares.
I saw
more people being just that have rejected the Lord. Where he has given them time and time again. And they just stand straight up. And
that goes along with my dream too, because in my dream, or not my dream, my vision, it was mostly attention was on the tares, and I felt that the Lord was actually going to sort of deal with the tares first. It's kind of what I felt in the vision.
What's interesting is in this whole picture, it was seen when the wheat and the tares were young, that the tares were planted among them. And they asked the master, do you want us to go in and pull out all the weeds, the tares? He said, no, let them grow together. He will send the messengers to harvest and reap and do the separation. He will do it. So with that in mind, the place you're called to is in worship. Because you paid a high price to be who you are today. The Most High is looking for the honor. Not the one you gave the enemy, but the one that you can now give him. Unreserved, which is the place we're looking for, because there's an expression of what he's done for you in the song and in the music that you will play. Nobody else can do that. It's to you. It's your appointment. It's something for you to give him in response for what he's done for you. Proper.
I used to think people were crazy when they would say, Mark, for 30 years, Mark, I see you in a Christian band. Mark, I see you worshiping God. Mark, why are you wasting your time with this music? And I wasn't close to the Lord, and I just always thought they were crazy.
It's true.
It would sound like that.
It's pretty awesome to just, like, how many times does this rockhead have to get it before you realize, okay, I am in.
And here's something else that goes with that. It may not be in the light in the big places.
Of course, and I don't care about
that. It may be in these kind of places where he gets to unleash his power through you.
Right.
In what you're going to play. because he wants to make it clear. He's after those who will worship him in spirit and in truth.
Yep. And, you know, I just would like to throw this out. That me and Gary have talked in the past on and off about, or I have said, oh, it sure be nice to have another person that could play another instrument with us. But as time goes on, I've realized you can't just have anybody play an instrument. I mean, if you're going to, you know, just seek the Lord, usher in, help to usher in the kingdom of God.
Yes.
You just can't, you know what I'm saying? But I just say all that to say, you know, I've had such peace, and I just feel the Lord's hand is calling and drawing you to do what you're doing, you know? And it's such a joy to have you play your guitar with us. It's such a joy.
It's a big thing for me. Even on my Facebook with my family, which 90% of the 12 of us are Christians, there's a few that aren't, but I was bragging about how God blessed me with this band and the cellos and all the instruments, and there was not a single person, even my friends who are heathens, said, wow, Mark, you should be in that orchestra type of band. This is so great. This is so much better than what you've done. And after, I don't know if it's part of my testimony on my Facebook, as I've been telling them about the church and the friends I've been hanging with, that my non-Christian friends are giving thumbs up, and they're, even if it's fake, the point is that someone's listening. Mm-hmm. And even my own family are just saying, we always knew you could do this, or you should do this. We've always prayed for you to be in that band that you want. And that's why I gave it up for almost 13 years. I just didn't know anybody, so I quit playing all my instruments. And people would say, Mark, why don't you play for us? And remember, family events, everyone in my family are musicians. So everybody be playing. And I would walk in, and they go, Mark's here, and they'd all put their guitars up. And they put unintentionally put me on this pedestal, which brings me back to the band. I hated it.
Yeah.
And so that's, you know, there. I don't know if it was Satan that put the sour taste in my mouth for the music, or what, but I just know in my heart it wasn't for God, so I didn't know any Christian songs, so I just didn't play anymore. And then Dan came up.
The Lord keeps reminding me of this thing. I was going to share, it sounds funny, but I think it's, you were saying how Satan put the sour taste in your mouth of, like, just wanting to stay away from it. And I feel like the enemy, yeah, it was the enemy that got you to kind of sort of isolate, to stop your music altogether. But you were saying it's been 13 years. And there's a scripture in Genesis where it says 13 years. After 13 years, they finally rebelled. And so you're rebelling against Satan's will for your life. And it's like you tolerated it.
Wow, that's pretty good.
You tolerated it for 13 years, but now it's time to rebel against Satan.
What scripture is this?
It's in Genesis. I'll have to find it for you.
Yes.
13 years and they
What was put in you is still in there.
Yes.
And it's been developed. It was developed over those long years where you spend out there doing what you did. But now he's going to bring it full circle. And it's going to be for him.
What the enemy meant for evil, Lord, to good.
That's right.
I'll tell you, one of the best things that's ever happened to me in my Christian walk with the Lord is he brought people like these people in my life. I've never had people in my life like all of you. And you know what? It's really helped change my life. Yeah. It really has. I really mean that.
Yeah.
It just... your influence, yeah. Just really, your influences. Wow. It's so important.
Another thing, in the few years I've been here, we've gone from working for the average Joe next door to we've remodeled at least 3 pastors' houses. We have prayed in the mornings on our job sites in the middle of the day. I have been surrounded by Christians, and it just blows me away because I just didn't ever imagine this was a possibility. I didn't know Christians lived this kind of life to this extent, which I understand why. I mean, I have such a heart for this. It's awesome.
And now we're playing rock and roll songs as a worship song. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. We're just really glad you're here.
Very happy that I'm here.
Yes.
You know, I get the feeling that you need to know that God ordered your steps all along the way. And you needed to do what you did.
That's right.
To be here, mm-hmm. and at all through those years that you were, you know, not playing and playing with the other band and all that stuff, God was working on your heart anyway.
That's right.
And it wouldn't be, what you're doing now would not be so sweet if you didn't experience the other stuff.
So, you know, you're talking about your family and all the I think I even read this last time, so I'm going to read it again. So, was thinking about your family and even the one that's not necessarily has totally believes at this point, but we know that they will. And so I want to just kind of speak this over your family, including everyone, those who understand, have a revelation, those that don't. But you're a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a consecrated nation, a special people for God's own possession, so that you may proclaim the excellencies, the wonderful deeds and virtues and perfections of Him who called you all out of darkness into His marvelous light. And it doesn't make any difference at what stage one comes out of darkness. That's not for you to judge. The point is that that's what God does. Once you were not a people at all, but you now are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy.
Mm-hmm.
So, Father, we just thank you that this whole family, this whole family called to be a royal priesthood, a consecrated nation, is truly the planting of the Lord. And Father, we just speak even blessings to them, Lord God, and we just pray that all would hear the sound of the Spirit and that all would hear the song of the Lord and rise up. Some will come out of darkness. Some will come out of the darkness of religion. Some will come out of darkness of self-pity. Some comes out of the darkness of shame. Some comes out of the darkness of not understanding. But Father, you call them all into your glorious light. Light of the truth of your love and the perfections of your mercies and the many graces that you have for them this next season, Father. I thank you, Lord God, that this next decade will be a decade of promise. They will be delivered from how they misunderstand who you are.
Yes, Lord.
And we thank you, Father. We thank you that your word is true.
Yes.
We thank you that your love is perfect.
Yes.
And it is huge for this family.
Yes,
yes.
Jesus.
What verse is
that?
You know, when I forgot where I wrote it down. I think that one is out of Amplified or Voice or something like that. I'd have to Google it because I didn't write it down.
Another scripture that was coming to me when you were talking about, like, Lord, why did it have to take me 66 years? not to worry about it and not to fret that, because God can do a lot in the last years of your life. And like, and He even shows that in the gospel, how His favor and grace can really come on someone even later in life. In Matthew 20, it's the parable of the laborers in the vineyard. And He hired three different ones, some early in the day, some in the middle of the day, and then some
like late. Yeah, I was thinking about that scripture verse.
Yeah. And they still all got paid the exact same.
I remember this.
And so God doesn't, you know, He doesn't treat every single person the exact same. There's different treasures.
Yep.
And you know, God can bring a lot of redemption in through like in people through where you've been and the people you've made relationship with. And as you become a light
it can draw them to the, to Christ, you know. But for me personally, I think one of the big reasons why I didn't grow much at certain times in my life is because I made the mistake of just being around bad influences, you know. It's not probably saying in retrospect, like, that might be one of the big reasons why, you know, you're 66 and now a lot of this, like, amazing stuff's happening. It's because you're getting around other, you know, people in the body. And so I would just really encourage you to continue to make sure, to even pray to the Lord, like, Lord, like, who do you want me to be around? Mm-hmm. And who do you want me to not be around? You know, and just kind of really follow
that's
the
good
Lord.
Too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That we set our minds on time.
Yes.
Yeah.
God does not.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
God doesn't have a time mind. And old men drink drinks.
Yeah.
Two things.
And women.
Two things. No matter how you start the race, you tell how you finish your race.
Yeah.
Okay.
Finishing well.
That's very good. That's actually makes so much sense right now.
And in regards to family, what you do now, you may not see the fruit or the effect in your day and age. But as a family man connected by bloodline to those brothers and sisters, what you stand for, the benefit may fall on them. What he asks you to do today, you may not receive the reward here, and it'll be up there. And that's putting money into eternity. You're into the eternal bank in that regard. So you don't have to worry about how effective you are going to be to your family. When you obey him and you start doing what he is going to ask you to do and start saying what he is going to ask you to say and start singing and playing what he's going to ask you, you're giving honor to him and you're giving glory to him by being obedient. You're giving the Most High glory by what you say, what you do. The instrument you're going to play, the music you're going to make, is going to give him glory because you're going to be able to put it into a frequency that's heard by other people. So don't worry about all of the other stuff. You don't know when it's going to benefit somebody. But you're just in a place where you're going to honor the living God for what he's done for you, and that's all you need at the moment. Because you can. You have what you need. It's already in there. It's going to come out again, and it's going to be even more refined than it was when you were on the stage, because you will have no fear. There will be no fear. No fear, because you're going to honor God and you're not going to honor him with fear. Yeah, true fear of him, but not the fear that the enemy had laid upon you to hinder you. Even though the gift was used like that, he still had something laid on you to hinder you in your in who you were and who you believed you were. No fear. You will. No fear.
Gosh, I feel so blessed. You know, worship to me too. The audience is the Lord. He's our audience, really. And when we focus on him,
9 and 10,
then this happens. You know what I mean?
Yes.
That's what I've been learning, is just focus on the Lord.
Yeah.
Lord, we need you so bad, and we can't do this without you. You know, we can't.
It's impossible.
We can't do it without the Lord.
Is there anything that anyone kind of just sort of got during worship corporately, or just like during worship, was there anything that anybody like kind of got in their spirit that we haven't had a chance to share yet? Yeah, just thought we'd just do that real quick.
Well, I got something for Susie.
Sure. Yeah. If you have a personal word too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where I know you have a whole lot, you know, you have a lot of depth, you know, in God and all. But I do believe he wants to give you more. I mean, blow your socks off more. Yeah.
I received that.
That's a good one.
Does she have socks on?
Thank you, Lisa.
Yeah.
Next time she comes here, she's not going to have her
socks on. She's not going to have socks on.
I don't have socks on right now. I don't like socks.
Oh.
They're too constricting.
Maybe that's why I...
Anita.
Yes. Oh, sorry.
What I... the word that came to mind for you...
Yes, please do share.
Was breakthrough.
Oh!
Oh, wow.
Yes, yay. Awesome. Thank you.
I don't know if that means anything to you or not, but that's...
Yeah, I mean, there's some areas where I need breakthrough. Thank you. Yes.
The word I hear is we want cupcakes, not pawpaws.
Well, there's cupcakes in there.
I saw that, too!
There is?
The benefit of pawpaws is greater than the benefit of cupcakes.
Say that again.
There's a what? What are pawpaws?
We want cupcakes and not pawpaws.
What are pawpaws?
Listen.
Okay.
We want cupcakes and not pawpaws. If you stop, I'll do it. I'll start again. Okay, we want cupcakes and not pawpaws. But the benefit of pawpaws is greater than the benefit of cupcakes. How so?
Yes.
Are you not vessels of gold? And need furnace application, pawpaws, to come to the other side and get the revelation that you get in the furnace, that you won't get otherwise.
Yeah.
The revelation you get in the furnace will not come to you any other place but in the furnace.
Right.
So the benefit of cupcakes is short-lived, but the benefit of pawpaws is eternal.
Oh my goodness, that's so good.
Right?
That's good.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, that is good.
Yes, you're right.
And so I'm going to have a cupcake.
You can have your cupcake and eat it too.
Idaho, and then whatever happened in December, and then COVID, and you know, it's like I've been yearning to be back with you all, and it's just so I had to grab my celebration shirt.
Yeah, very good. And there's cupcakes in there.
I'm gonna get one.
That's funny.
Yeah. Wow.
And I'll wear this one in the winter. It's not a long sleeve sweater.
That is so cool.
That is awesome.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would really like the Lord. I just have a hunger to go deeper in worship and take the Lord's people deeper. Yeah. But I just feel like, just like that the Lord, for all of us, all the worshipers here, that just prayer that the Lord would help us to do that.
Yeah.
Because in our self, we don't know how to do that. You know what I mean?
No, we don't.
But
God can do it.
Yeah. Yeah, right.
I just feel the Lord wants that.
Yeah.
But... So maybe that the Lord would give us.
Yes, that's a good prayer.
Is it wisdom or?
He'll just lead you.
Whatever.
Yeah.
However it's supposed to look. You know.
I feel like tonight.
You did.
I felt breakthrough.
Oh yeah.
I feel like now's the time.
Yeah.
But I just like Gary keeps talking to me all the time about going where we've never been, and I have the same hunger he has, but it's like, gosh, Lord, what is it? You know, I just anyway.
Yeah.
So maybe something like that, that the Lord would help us.
Yeah.
And for Mark, you know. And
yeah.
So, because we do. We want to go.
Yeah, we do.
We want to experience the glory of the Lord, you know.
Yeah.
You know, it's interesting because I remember you saying, you'd like to play the guitar with me.
Mm.
Well, I got my guitar out.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
God, no, I'm sure so knows how many years.
I know.
That's cool.
Well,
it is.
Put the new string on it, and you know, and then I was tuning it, but the high one, as I was twisting it, it literally bent.
Up in here?
Yes.
You
want
to tune the key?
But the thing that holds the key. So I thought, you've got to be kidding, God. Here I finally do it, and the guitar breaks, you know. Tonight, It's like I was thinking, and when you were saying, yeah, does anyone want to? I thought, oh man, I haven't played for a long time. My calluses are gone, you know, and strength. And anyway, and I feel it, this is for me, but I feel what you're just saying. This is what I said, you know, it's like, well, go get a, you know, six string guitar. Well, when I was playing, it was a folk guitar, nylon strings. I always wanted a 12 string. Mm-hmm. And God just said, I broke your guitar. Go get your 12 string. Ah! More.
Yeah. Cool. Double it.
Wow.
More.
Hallelujah.
So with that in mind, what you experienced, there's a place of zeal for who he is to you that you're willing to express. Mm-hmm. When it comes in through your music, what you put in the guitar, and it comes out those strings, it's going to be real.
Wow.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Because he's looking for people to be real with him first. If I'm not real with him, I have nothing to give you. Mm-hmm. I have nothing to give you if I can't be real with him about what he's dealing with me with. Mm-hmm. How he's talking to me, what he's bringing up, what I have to do, which I changed to wanting to do, because the alternative, I don't even want that. There's a severity in the kindness that he expresses mm-hmm. to us. That we are supposed to give others. We give have others. To stand yeah. in the place of pawpaws when the cupcakes are off. Okay, we have to. Because we can't color it any other color but a pawpaw. When a pawpaw comes, there's a reason behind it. He's looking to change our perspectives on so many things. It stood between us and him for generations. We are the last. Okay, he saves the best for last. What's that say about you and everything that you've gone through to this point? Something more is in order. He's after that. We have to get to a place in order for that to happen.
Well, when the guitar broke, you know, it's like, oh, I don't know about fixing this thing, you know, the way it is. I just said, okay, forget it then. I'm not supposed to. But tonight, then I'm thinking, I'm too old to start up.
No, that's not true. Not true. Young woman, you young woman.
Sarah, yeah.
Sarah was old too.
Sarah was old.
And look what he did with her.
Yeah.
Yeah. We're a blip on the radar of eternity. Our life's there and gone.
Right.
But you have a certain style to sing and worship, mm-hmm. unlike anybody else, that'll bless people. So I would encourage you to, you know, play and sing.
Sing.